You have to be in time. You have to be punctual. Okay, now we'll start, children. So our topic was cell structure and functions. So again, we'll have a quick recap of everything. So here, firstly, the cell. What is a cell? Cell is a fundamental unit of life. Structural and fundamental unit of life. Okay, just 1 second, children. I'll just try to add. First of all,
good.
Yes. So, coming to the discovery of the cell, who discovered the cell? Yes, I'll just want to ask. I'll unmute you and I'll ask you. Yes, Rishit Rao, just unmute yourself and tell me who discovered the cell. Rishit Rao, you can unmute yourself.
Ma'am.
Yes, Rishit.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell me who discovered the cell? Rishit, I can't hear you properly. Yes, keep your camera and raise your hands if you can give me the answer.
Ma'am, from Robert Hooke, ma'am.
Yes, Robert Hooke. Okay, good. Robert Hooke. And who discovered the nucleus in the cell? Who discovered nucleus in a cell? Anyone? You can raise your hands if you know the answer. Just keep your camera so that I can see you raising your hands. Just wait 1 second, children. Someone's calling me. Hello? Yes? Yes, who is this? Okay, yes, Ratwik. No, ma. I have eighth grade. Yes, I have 8th grade. And next period I have 7th. So I can't take the class today. Okay. Yes, children. So, you can hear me? Yes. Yes, Akshara. You can unmute yourself.
Ma'am, it was invented by Robert Brown.
Good. It was invented by Robert Brown.
In the year 1837.
1831. 31. Yes. Okay, good, Akshara. So now, can anyone just tell me what is a cell called as?
A cell is called as the fundamental unit of life.
Okay, good. And what is the study of cell? Just Akshara, I just want to give the chance to someone, other children also. Yes, Hanish, can you tell me what is the study of cell known as? You can unmute yourself. What is the study of cell called? Hanish, you can unmute yourself. Yes, Nayana, can you give me the answer? Yes.
Ma'am, must repeat question, ma'am. I'll tell.
The study of cell is called
cytology or cell biology.
Okay, good. Okay, children. Just 1 second. Yes. So the study of cell is called as cell biology or cytology. So this is the structure of cell, children. Here you can see the different organelles which are present inside the cell. So you all have to name them. You have to draw it, a neat diagram, and you have to label its parts. So as we have finished everything, so now here we'll have a quick recap of everything. Here you can see the structure of various cells. The different structure of these cells is because they function. They can perform different types of functions because they have due to which they have different shape and size. Each cell has its capacity to perform a certain basic function. So here you can see the different types of organisms. The types of organisms are divided into unicellular and multicellular. You can see in this picture what are the unicellular organisms and what are the multicellular organisms. So the unicellular organisms are the amoeba and paramecium. They have only a single cell. They have originated from a single cell. So that is why they are called as unicellular organisms. Yes, Hanish, you have any doubt? Why you have raised your hand, Hanish? Yes. Hanish, you have any doubt? I can't hear your voice properly.
Ma'am, you asked me something, ma'am. What is it, ma'am?
Yes, yes. At that time, you were not audible to me. I think you can't be able to hear my voice also. Yes. I asked you, what is the study of cell called?
I don't know.
Study of cell is called as cell biology or cytology. Okay, Hanish?
Oh, okay.
You can be able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here, children, the unicellular organisms are originated from only a single cell. And the examples for them are amoeba, paramecium, and bacteria. And the examples of multicellular organisms are the animals, plants, and even human beings also. So now coming to unicellular and multicellular organisms, children. Here, firstly, we'll just see the unicellular organisms like amoeba and bacteria. So they can carry out the reproduction, they can feed, and even they can digest, and even excretion process also takes place, as we have learned in our earlier classes, in our previous class also, what is the process of digestion and how all these life processes goes on in amoeba and bacteria. So now coming to cell, children, I just want to discuss about the cell structure. Firstly, what are the organelles which are present? Just look at this slide. The structural organization of a cell. As we have just seen this picture of the cell, there are so many organelles which are present inside the cell, isn't it? You can see the different organelles. So now we'll see in detail about this organelles. Firstly, the outer covering of the cell is called as the plasma membrane or the cell membrane. The cell membrane is the outer cover of the animal cell, but for plant, it is the second layer. First layer is the cell wall. A plant cell have a cell wall in the beginning. It has a cell wall first for a plant cell. This is the difference, children. This is the difference. You must be able to write the difference between a plant cell and an animal cell. So here, what is the difference? A plant cell have a cell wall. And for an animal cell, it has only what it has? Yes? Can anyone just tell me? What is the difference between a plant cell and an animal cell? Yes, Amit, you have raised your hand. You can unmute yourself. Yes, Amit, you want to tell something? Yes, Akshara.
Ma'am, yes. Animal cell has the plasma membrane as the first layer.
Yes.
And the plant cell has the second layer.
Good.
Because the plant cell has the first layer as the cell wall.
Good. Okay. Yes, Amit, you want to tell something? You can unmute yourself.
Ma'am, repeat again, ma'am. Unicellular organisms.
Okay. So Amit wants to hear once again about the unicellular and multicellular organisms. This one you want. So here, organisms are divided into two types, unicellular and multicellular. So here, the difference between unicellular and multicellular is unicellular organisms like amoeba and paramecium, they are originated from only a single cell. They can carry out, only a single cell can carry out different functions like digestion, ingestion, assimilation, okay, feeding, reproduction, excretion, and all a single cell can carry out. But the multicellular organisms have different types of functions they can carry out. Like, for example, in animals, they can move, they have different types of organs arranged inside them, isn't it? For digestion purpose, they have digestive system. There are so many systems like reproductive system, digestive system, respiratory system, excretory system, isn't it? They have so many complicated systems. They have so many organs inside them. In multicellular organisms, they have so many cells, isn't it? So many cells put together, they form tissues. Tissues combined together forms organs. Organs combined together form organ systems. But in what? In multicellular organisms. Now unmute yourself, Amit. Amit, unmute yourself.
Ma'am.
Yes. Is it clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now are you able to tell me what is the difference between unicellular and multicellular organisms? Just tell me, what are unicellular organisms? Okay, just read. You can see this slide. Amit, you can see this slide. You can see your screen. You can see this on your screen. You can see. Yes, Ritvika, you have any doubt? You can unmute yourself. Ritvika,
ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, why animals are not having cell wall, ma'am?
Animal
what is the main reason?
Animal cell do not have cell wall. Why? Because it is semi-permeable. It has the information in the form of DNA and messenger RNAs and proteins. They all enter. They get inside. They even come outside. The letting in and out of the cell takes place because of its semi-permeable nature of the nature of what? Through what they come in and come out? Plasma membrane. The plasma membrane is semi-permeable. Because of the semi-permeable nature of this plasma membrane, the information is coming in. The information is let in and out of the cell. Why I have shown you why this process is necessary? Because the cell, it sends the important information out of it in the form of messenger RNA or the proteins which are needed to other parts of the body. They are being produced inside the cell and they are sent outside the cell. After the proteins are generated, after so many important things are generated inside the cell, and then they come out of the cell. and they go to that particular organ where there is a need of that proteins or where there is a need of the information, isn't it? You know that the cell have now further in this lesson we even have learned about the nucleus and the DNA genetic material is present inside the nucleus of the cell, isn't it? Okay, so what happens is the information is getting in and it is getting out. So because of this, the layer is semi-permeable. And but in plants, they have a cell, rigid cell wall. Why? Because it is the outer layer, it is the outer covering, it is a protective covering of the plant cell to avoid the plant from other things to get inside. If the water, for example, if the excess of water is there, if the layer is not, if the cell wall is not rigid, then what happens? The water will enter inside and the plant will die because of excess of water.
It will swell, ma'am.
Yes, it will swell and it will die. So to avoid that, there is a cell wall. Okay, is it clear now? Is it clear, children? Okay. So anyone have doubt, just raise your hands so that I can clear and I can proceed to the topic further. Yes, Ritvika, you have any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Just put your hand down, lower your hand then. I'll be confused if you just raise your hands like that. Yes, Nayana, you have any doubt?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Ma'am, I'll explain again about cell wall, ma'am.
Cell wall, okay. So here on the screen, if you can see, you can see the cell wall?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So just one second. So here you can clearly see the cell wall. So in animal cell, you can see the plasma membrane or the cell membrane. Cell membrane is also called as the plasma membrane. So this plasma membrane is the first layer in animal cell and it is the second layer in the plant cell. You can see clearly the plasma membrane is beneath the cell wall. Why? Because the plants have cell wall first and then comes the cell membrane.
Why, ma'am?
Because the plant, the cell wall, it cells, it needs rigidity to avoid the swelling of the cells. Because if it takes in excess of water inside, then the plant cell will swell and then it burst. To avoid that, there is a rigid layer called the cell wall. First, okay. It has cell wall in plants. But in animal cells, there are so many cells. So that's why the animals are called as multicellular, isn't it? So these cells, because of its nature, they have to let in and out the information, important information and proteins and so many things. They have to come inside the cell and go out. There are so many messenger RNAs also, isn't it? They pass the information. They come inside the messenger RNAs and they go inside the nucleus. They carry the important information from there. They'll ask the information. They go near the nucleus. They carry the information and they go out of the cell. To allow this, the cell wall, the plasma membrane is semi-permeable. Means they have small pores. Those pores, the things like messenger RNA or anything, they can come inside easily and they can go outside. Okay.
Okay.
So here I'll just.
Ma'am, this Sunday we have a GM, ma'am.
Yes, I can't hear you.
We have GM, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. I have to even give you the information that you have the GA too, this Sunday. And I have included this chapter.
On what topic, ma'am?
This chapter only, the fundamental unit of life.
Okay, ma'am.
Prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. unicellular or multicellular organisms I have included, okay? And okay. You must not repeat the mistakes which you have done previously. We have instructed you not to come out and not to, because you cannot write, you cannot go in and write again, okay? It may show errors. So please avoid doing mistakes again and again. Okay, so please go through this chapter, go through this unit, week two, you have to go through, okay? Week three also, week four I haven't given. So now, is it clear till here, children? I'll show you one video so that it'll be clear. So now coming to cell wall is the outermost layer in the plant cell. It lies outside the plasma membrane. It is very rigid in nature, made up of cellulose. It is made up of cellulose. Cellulose is nothing but a complex substance that provides structural strength to the plants. Because of its rigid nature, it provides structural strength to the plants. Cell wall permits the cells of plants, fungi, and bacteria to withstand very dilute hypotonic external media without bursting. Cell wall, what cell wall do? Cell wall avoid these things to get inside. Like fungi and bacteria, they can't be able to get inside quickly. And it can even withstand very dilute hypotonic external media. Like it will not allow the water to get inside quickly because the cell wall is there. It is rigid in nature. And it prevents the cell from bursting. In such media, the cells tend to take up water by osmosis. The cells swells, building up pressure against the cell wall. The cell wall exerts equal amount of pressure against the swollen cells. During the osmosis process, if the osmosis takes place, if the cells are kept inside the hypotonic solution, like if they are, the water is surrounding them, and now the water is coming in, and then the cells are swelling, then the cell wall, what it does, it exerts equal amount of pressure. It will not allow the cells to swell more and more. They will take in the limited amount of water till where they can swell, and then they won't allow the water to let inside. The wall will prevent it. Is it clear? Okay, now coming to nucleus. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. I'll give you 10 minutes, last 10 minutes to clear your doubts. Now children, coming to nucleus. Nucleus was first discovered by Robert Brown in 1831. And the nucleus which is present in the cells is present in the cell except in RBC. In RBCs, there is no nucleus. It controls and regulates the activities of the cell. Now I just want to discuss about the, just one second, cytoplasm. You have the cytoplasm also and the functions of nucleus. The nucleus plays a central role in cellular reproduction, the process by which a single cell divides and forms two new cells. It also plays a crucial part along in the environment by determining the way the cell will divide. We will go through the cell division also at the last of this topic. In the unit 4, we'll be discussing about the cell division also. Now children, coming to cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the fluid content which is present inside the plasma membrane. It also contains many specialized cell organelles inside the cell. We all know that there are so many cell organelles. And where these cell organelles are present, they are present inside the fluid material called the cytoplasm. Inside the cell, there is the cytoplasm. The fluid called cytoplasm is there inside the cell. And in that fluid, all these organelles will be there. Like organelles like mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, and the nucleus, isn't it? So all these organelles will be present inside the fluid called cytoplasm. So now the significance of membranes can be illustrated with the example of virus. Do virus have all these? No, they don't have cell machinery. They don't have any organelles. Virus don't have any organelles. They have only the genetic material. They have either the DNA or the RNA. What they do is they carry only the genetic material. Virus don't have any cell wall. They don't have any organelles. Virus have only the genetic material. So this virus, what it does, it enters into the living cell and it tries to multiply itself. It tries to use the cell organelles from the cell. Virus attack the cell, it enters into it, and then it utilizes the cell organelles because it don't have its own organelles. Okay, you have any doubts? Just raise your hands. Yes, children, just 1 second. I'll just unmute you all so that you can just ask me. Just raise your hands if you have any doubts, children. Till here, you have any doubts? Yes, you can unmute.
Ma'am, once you repeat what you said, just no, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, once you repeat.
Okay, okay, I'll repeat it. So this class will end, ma. Okay, just mute yourself so that I can repeat it. So here, the cell, usually in the cell, the organelles which are placed, different types of organelles are there inside the cell. We all know that. If you see this picture, 1 second, I'll just keep this picture. Yes, if you can see this picture here, the cell at your left side, you can see a cell. There are so many organelles, isn't it? Like nucleus, mitochondria, vacuole, Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, everything is there placed inside the cell. So there is a fluid, the sky blue color fluid is there, na? Blue color fluid. That fluid is called as cytoplasm. That fluid is called as cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the fluid content inside the plasma membrane. It contains so many organelles inside it. But in virus, they don't have these organelles. These organelles are called as cell machinery because they do a lot of work, isn't it? All the mitochondria has its own work. It does its own function. Golgi apparatus does its own function. What is the function? What is mitochondria called as? What is the other name of mitochondria? What is mitochondria called as? It is the powerhouse of the cell.
Powerhouse of the cell.
Yes, it is the powerhouse of the cell. Yes, so this type of machinery, so these are all called as a cell machinery because they perform their own work inside the cell. They'll try to produce proteins, they'll try to generate energy, they'll try to generate different types of things. Nucleus try to generate the genetic material. Nucleus has its own function. So this cell machinery, the virus don't have the cell machinery. What it does is, the virus comes and attack the living cell. It enters into our body. For example, I'm telling, it enters into the body. What it does is, it just go and sits on the cell. It sits on the live cell of our body. And it tries to inject the genetic material which it has. The virus only have the genetic material and it tries to inject its genetic material. Then where the genetic material goes? It goes near the nucleus. It enters into the nucleus. it tries to attach with the DNA of the cell. It tries to combine with the genetic material of the nucleus. And then it completely tries to change the genetic material. It also tries to bind along with that our cell genetic material. And now all the codes are changed. Everything is changed, isn't it? Now our body starts to fall sick. Why? Because the virus came and attacked our body. And don't know what that virus is. What type of disease it trying to spread. So our body, now our body starts feeling sick. Our body is now diseased. Tomb of the cell. Nucleus is called as brain or the control room of the cell. Because now what is the control room of your body? Your brain controls everything, isn't it? Your brain sends and yes, your brain controls each and everything. It gives you information that go and hold that. If you are seeing any delicious fruit or any delicious food, then your brain will tell that go and eat that. It is looking very delicious, isn't it? Your brain controls. So in the same way, the cell brain is called as nucleus. Nucleus is called as a cell brain or the control room. It controls all the functions of the different organelles which are present. It controls all the functions. Each and every cell has its own nucleus. We all know that each and every cell has different organelles, including the nucleus. All tiny,
RBC don't have nucleus, ma'am.
They don't have nucleus, ma, because they have to take in the information. They have to just they can just carry the information. They are the red blood corpuscles which just flow. I'll just give you a few more detail about it tomorrow. While we start the class, I'll just give you the more information about that. Okay. And even about the WBCs also. And even I'll show you more information regarding the virus also, how it attacks, so that you can easily understand. I'll show you one video I was about to show you, but there is very less time remain now. So we'll carry out tomorrow. Okay, now coming to the nucleus, children. What are the parts of nucleus? So now here you can see small pores in the picture. There are small pores inside the nucleus also.
Yes,
why,
ma'am.
Why they have small pores on the nucleus also? We know that plasma membrane is semi-permeable. It has small pores. But here to the nucleus also it has small pores. Why? Why it is also semi-permeable? What are these red dots? What are these red dots on this nucleus? Those are the ribosomes. Okay? Those are the ribosomes. And okay. Even they have pores to transmit the information, to transmit the genetic material, have information inside the nucleus. We all know that. To transmit this information.
Ma'am, I have a doubt, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, yes, what is the difference between nucleus, nucleoplasm and nucleolus, ma'am?
I'll tell you. Nucleus is the material which is present in the middle. It has the main genetic material like DNA. DNA is the genetic material, we all know that. So inside this nucleus, a genetic material is there and it is covered with a covering called the nuclear envelope. Inside that nuclear envelope, there is again a fluid. The fluid called nucleoplasm. The nucleus is not a single thing. The nucleus again has parts. The main nucleus, which has the genetic material, it is present in the middle. It is called as the nucleolus. It is called as nucleolus. in which the genetic material is there. The nucleolus will be suspended in the fluid called the nucleoplasm. The fluid is called as nucleoplasm. Inside that nucleoplasm, nucleolus will be present. Where the genetic material is present? Now you just tell me, where is the genetic material?
In nucleus.
In nucleolus.
Oh, sorry, ma'am. In nucleolus.
In nucleolus. Now, where is this nucleolus present? Inside the fluid. Inside
nucleolus.
The fluid. It is suspended in the fluid. What is that fluid?
Nucleolus.
Nucleoplasm.
Yes,
the
ma'am.
Fluid in which nucleolus is suspended is called as nucleoplasm. And don't be get confused. What is the fluid in which all the cell organelles are there?
Cytoplasm.
Yes, good. It is cytoplasm. Like that, well, the fluid of cytoplasm in the same
hello, ma'am.
Way. Yes, tell me. Now the class will end, ma. There is only less than 1 minute left.
No, ma'am. Time completed, ma'am.
Yes, time completed. I have sent the homework also. So, to your class teacher.